friends. How's everyone this morning? I hope you're doing well. I'm going to make my my brew this morning. It's not tea, and it's not something I'm going to drink. It's worm tea, and I need a new batch. I've needed it for a couple weeks, and it's that time, in Florida, we go through a winter and things slow down. And even though I'm, keeping things going, and we can garden pretty much all year long in Central Florida, you still slow down and you just keep things kind of the status quo there. But come spring, you want to start giving everybody that little bit of a kickstart. So I'm going to make my worm tea. And I'm going to start off. You can see I save all sorts of containers. Pardon the noise. I could have done this before. Sorry. Worm tea is really good because it has all the microbes, it has all the different things growing in it that the worm castings do. And worm castings, of course, come from the worms. And when you take their castings and you soak them in rainwater, especially, if you don't have rainwater, then take your clear water, even if it's chlorinated, and let it sit out. And let it sit open so that any chlorine or bleaches or anything like that will dissipate. Now, I normally will use this is a 5 gallon bucket, and I'll normally put in about 4 gallons, but I want to use this right away. My birthday, by the way, is in a couple days, and we do a birth week for each other, and one of the births week gifts that I ordered and then gave it to Rick to give to me, when you get older you just do things like this, was Rhonda Sherman's the handbook for worm farming. And if you get a chance, she's a very interesting professor at North Carolina University, and she's been doing this for like 35 years or something, where I'm on there. But she had mentioned that when you do make worm tea, use it right away. Sometimes when you buy it, like Captain Matt, if you have a chance, check out his channel, Captain Matt Worms. He sells his worm tea, and of course you can buy worm tea anywhere. But if you see it and it's in a dark container or an opaque container, then you know that it's going to be protected from the UV rays, because the microbes are living in there, and they're not going to live a long time if they have sunlight against them. But Rhonda had mentioned that she said when you make your worm tea, make it and use it. So I thought, that's very smart. So I've only gotten 3 gallons of liquid. And to that, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of unsulphured, make sure it's unsulphured molasses. And you can see I'm out here and I have a clean little measuring spoon. This isn't really rocket science or an exact here on the molasses, but the molasses will feed the bacteria because they like things sweet. I do too, and I'm not even a microbe, not even a bacteria, just me. So then you wonder, how's all that going to work here? I'm not a great fan of molasses personally, so that's strictly for the worms. So we'll take that back in and wash it. That's done. Now we have water. You can have 1 gallon, 2 gallons, 3 gallons. Have as many gallons as you want. Add a tablespoon. if you're a little shy, if you're over, if nobody's counting. Okay, now we're going to add our worm castings. I did get these from my worms probably a few weeks ago, a month ago, and I actually sifted these. I didn't need to, but I sifted them because I wanted to be able to sprinkle it in my garden, and I didn't want them to be clumpy. But that worked out just fine, no problems here. And there's different, I mean, this is just a nylon bag. It had cosmetics in it. And but there's all sorts of bags that you can get. But if you watch, Captain Matt had a really great video on how he makes this very simple worm tea. And what he does is he uses 5 pounds of castings to about 5 pounds of to about 5 gallons of water. So since I only have 3 gallons, this is probably 4 pounds of casting. Again, it's not an exact measurement. So I'm going to see if this will work for me. I'm hoping it does. I'm not be getting it everywhere and anywhere. I'm not the neatest person, although I try extremely hard. That is nice. Ooh, that is nice. I don't see any worms left in there. Okay, so now I'm just going to draw this tight, sort of, and use whatever you want to use. Your whole idea is that you're going to dangle this so that it can circulate in the, I think I found one. Yep, that looks like it will. That will too. All right, so I have my water. I have my molasses. Now I have my castings. Now we want to oxygenate this. And the way I'm going to do it is I bought, this is an air pump that you use like for your fish, I think. And very simple. I think it was online. I think it was less than $14. It has a little control. I'm going to go ahead and plug it in here once I show you. Here's the two little air stones. And I'm afraid you're not going to be able to hear it because the fountain's on. I'm outside, the wind's blowing, et cetera, et cetera. But I will for sure tell you. Come on, I know I can find one. There we go. Here's my control. Oh, I can see bubbles. Alright, so I've got my bubbles going. It also has a control on whether you want it full or you want it... Ooh, now we're really pumping. Get it? It's an air pump. Can you see that? No, probably not, but trust me, it is. Alright, now the last thing we're going to do is dangle this good old worm poop in here. It'll take just a minute for it to sink. There it went. Okay, so now this is set up. And I can let this go for 24 hours, 48 hours, however long I want. And this water will just, you know, will turn to a, it'll be a dark tea color, you know, like an English breakfast, a tea color. And then what I'll do is I will take this back out and I'll let it drain, and I can still use those castings. You know, just the way I could a tea bag that I've already gotten a couple of cups of tea out of, I can take that leaves and use it somewhere else. Well, these are still castings. There's still the poop from the worms. So that will come back out, and I can, what I will normally do is, instead of letting it dry out again, I'll take it out and use it in my garden, and I'll take, you know, like this is probably a 10 cup container, 8 cup container. I'll take a scoop of it and I'll put it in my my watering can, shake it around, get it, you know, going, and then I will give everybody a distribution of worm castings that have been watered down, and that will go more into the surface. I think sometimes whenever it sits on the surface, it's not as effective because, like I said, the UV rays will come down, you've got the sun shining on it, and so it kind of breaks it down without being absorbed. And so I think that's probably it. I will go ahead, once I'm done with it, and I'll go ahead and put it back into my containers, even though they are almost see-through. And I'll mix this like a 10 to 1. I could just pour it on my plants, but that seems like kind of a waste. So I'll go ahead and use it a 10 to 1. It's supposed to be very, very effective. And that's the end of it. I think that it's a great thing to have. Now, if you want to give me excuses, the reasons why you can't do it. Okay, what are the reasons why you can't do it? Well, I don't have any place to collect rainwater. Okay, well, I've answered that one. You can use any kind of water. If it's chlorinated, let it sit out. I don't have worms. Okay. Well, you can make a tea out of so many other things. If you have bananas peel, you can make a potassium rich. If you have onions, you can soak your onion skins in water, and you can get a brew that, if you spray it on your plants, it will deter certain, aphids or mealybugs or any of the pests in a natural way. Help me. What are some of the other things that we could think of? Drawing a blank there, but basically, you know, like potato skins, any of the skins. You can really make one that's incredible by just taking your weeds and putting them in a bucket and putting water in there, and then make sure you cover it. I mean, they will really rot well, and as they're rotting well and breaking down, they're just the microbe bacteria that's growing is actually a good thing. And when you take that off a couple weeks later, it will knock you over, I've been told. And then you just take really tiny amounts of it and put it in your water and add it to your plants. So you're growing your soil, because you want to grow the soil to grow the plants. Okay, so let's see, do we have any other excuses? Oh, here's one, and I think this is just fascinating. I have a friend, his channel is called Merluth, M-E-R-U-L-T-H, and he's really, his photography is tremendous, and young guy, young student, and he said, oh, I don't have a bubbler. I said, what do you do to oxygenate? He said, I have like two containers. I'm sure it's, you know, like an open container, and he said, I just pour one to the other, one to the other, one to the other. That action adds oxygen into something. And he said, after however long he's doing it, he's young, he can probably do it a lot longer than me. He said, I feel like I've added a lot of oxygen into my water. You know, it's like, you know, H2O, he's adding more O to it. And so these are all, if you're thinking of why can't I do it, well, if you want to, you can. So anyway, that was all I really wanted to show you. I'm making it, and so I thought if you have any questions on how to do this, please get back to me. Let me know. Again, tomorrow I will pull this back out. See, I'll take it back out, and I will use my tea, my drippings off of there. Now I can use another, you know, because it's been pushed and pulled, you know, had air ran through it, there's probably sediment that will get in there. And, well, I know there's sediment that will get in there because I use it in my spray bottle, and this pump here has a real fine little mesh at the bottom. And if I use the worm tea in it, after I get kind of to the bottom of it, then I'll see that there's sediment that's attaching itself to it. But I could take another bag and then just go through it again. If you have a coffee filter, you could run it through the coffee filter and let it come through that. It would probably take a little bit of time, but you know, that time is all we have. So anyway, if you have any questions, let me know. And I hope you'll subscribe and ring the bell. Give me a thumbs up if you want. And I hope you'll watch it. I really would appreciate if you'd watch it. I could really use the hours. I do have my 1,000 subscribers, but I'm like not even halfway on the hours. So it would certainly be nice to be recognized by YouTube at some point in my life. So anyway, I hope everybody has a great day. Remember, garden what you've got, and I promise I will see you the next time. Come back and see me again soon.